Use the graph to identify zeros and multiplicity. Order your zeros from least to greatest. So the zeros are locations where the graph is going to either touch the x-axis or pass through the x-axis. And these would be real zeros, complex zeros that doesn't occur. But we can identify these because they're quite prevalent. You can see them touching the x-axis here, the graph passes through here, and passes through here. So those three points are the locations of zeros. So we have -3, x equals -1, and x equals 2. So those are my three zeros. Now, multiplicity. Multiplicity is identifiable through the graph by identifying what's happening around that point. So at a zero, if the graph kind of looks like on a small window, so small little range, if it looks sort of like a parabola, so we're touching the axis and bouncing away. So parabolas are degree 2 polynomials, so this makes this zero degree 2, which we just say multiplicity 2. And if around the zero, it looks like the graph is just a line passing through the axis, then that means you have degree 1 zero, which is the same thing as saying multiplicity 1.